I am Pham Chi Dung, independent journalist, chairman of Independent Journalist Association of Vietnam, IGAVN. Founded in 2014, the association is a civil organization consisting of more than 70 journalists and operates independently. IGAVN and I keenly concerned about the strike EU's Vietnam Free Trade Agreement, EVFTA, and Investment Protection Agreement, IPA, and their coming ratification. I am wondering why some of EU's representatives are too eager to have EVFTA and IPA ratified regardless of the EU's trade deficit with Vietnam and human rights violation, whereas human rights improvements is the core value of the agreement and also part of the EU's support to democracy around the world. The EU's trade deficit with Vietnam widened annually and up to $20 to $25 billion. As the trade deficit rate reflect, Vietnam is likely to be a main beneficiary of EU's Vietnam trade deals, but not the EU's. There might be only a small group of EU's companies, but not all EU's business benefiting from the agreements. It is obvious that a number of particular EU's business groups have the EVFTA and IPA lobbied by the former head of the delegations of the European Union in Vietnam, Bruno Asley, and some EU's representatives, but neglect the serious human rights abuse of the Vietnamese government. At EU's Vietnam human rights dialogue in the recent years, fuelless. I estimate roughly 95% of the EU's recommendations of human rights being ignored of offering false promises. The only progress in human rights is supporting LGBT community, and it did not affect the one-party rule system and dictatorships in country. There are a number of activities that would mark the contribution of the EU's pressing Vietnam to release two prominent prisoners of conscience, Nguyễn Văn Đài and blogger Nguyễn Ngọc Như Quỳnh in 2018. However, Vietnam intensified crackdown against rights activists and dissidents. Since the new cyber security law came to effect in January 2019, Vietnam imprisoned 18 dissidents because they criticized the government and its corruption system. In November 2018, European Parliament, EP, issued the resolutions on Vietnam, notably the Situation of Human Rights 2018-2925 RSP. The resolutions addressed most of human rights violations in the country, such as labor, freedom of religion, press and expression on the internet, prisoners of conscience, and called for significant improvements. The local activists were impressed by the resolutions, and they were looking forward changes in the political and right atmosphere. However, Vietnam had complied with only a minor part of the resolutions by EVFTA and IPA was signed in Hanoi on June 30, 2019. Hanoi has so far ratified 5 International Labour Organization, ILO, Convention 98 on collective bargaining, and set timeline for the ILO Convention 87 on the right to organize, and Convention 105 on the abolition of forced labor between 2023 and 2025. There is no detailed timeline for ratification of any guarantee that Hanoi will meet their commitments. Hanoi considers independent union as reactionary idea because of the impact of Polish the trade union solidarity on the fall of communist system in Poland in 1989. Vietnam's delay in signing the 87th convention is essentially a timeless seek and hopes to frustrate the EU and the International Labour Organization without requiring Vietnam to sign the 87 Convention again. The term independent trade union is not included in the ongoing revisions of Vietnam's labor code and trade union law, but a complicated process for those who intend to found no state trade union. The violations of human rights is intensive and Hanoi hardly make any improvements in its human rights records. The police harass and imprison rights activists, from a film producer who makes films about land rape victims to a female anti-BOT activist. There has not been any sign of any human rights improvements, either demagogical or to deal with the international community. 13 years after Vietnam became the 150th member of the World Trade Organization, Vietnam repeats its tactics. In 2006, Vietnam made some progress on human rights to host the US President George Bush in Hanoi, and then Vietnam was removed from the TPC list and joined the World Trade Organization in January 2007. 1 year later, 2008, Vietnam imprisoned more dissidents and convicted up to 50 political prisoners annually. The regime is likely to jail more dissidents after the EU ratified the EVFTA and IPA. Prominent dissidents who opposed EVFTA due to Vietnam's poor human rights record and those who stand up against China will receive heavy prison sentences. With all the above mentioned reasons, I would like to call the European Parliament to postpone the ratifications of the EVFTA and IPA until the Vietnam regime fulfills its commitments on human rights and proves that Vietnam complies with the resolution 2018-2925 RSP issued by European Parliament. Thank you.